Alma Linux 10 is here, and as you might expect, it sticks close to Red Hat Enterprise Linux 10, but they are also adding a few community-requested features on top. Let's start with hardware compatibility. Alma Linux OS 10 has followed Red Hat's decision to ship x86-64-v3 optimized binaries by default, but they will also provide additional x86-64-v2 architecture, allowing users on that older hardware to continue to receive security updates for another 10 years. Red Hat dropped support for older CPUs in RHEL 10. Alma Linux decided to keep it going, which is great for people who are running that older hardware. For those who are curious why the transition, Red Hat's shift to an x86-64v3 baseline in RHEL 10 enables the operating system to leverage advanced CPU features introduced with Intel's Haswell, which was in 2013, and AMD's Excavator, which is in 2015, and these microarchitectures. These features include AVX2, FMA, and BMI2 instruction sets, which enhances performance for compute-intensive tasks by allowing better vectorization and more efficient mathematical operations. But this is also great for Alma Linux because it makes it possible for those who want to use the older hardware to still keep it around by having the support for the V2 rather than just the V3. So that's good to see. Another request that has been fulfilled by the Alma Linux team is that developers wanting frame pointers. So Alma Linux OS 10 is now enabling frame pointers by default. This makes real-time tracing and performance profiling way easier and essential for optimizing apps on production systems. Also, Alma Linux OS 10 now supports secure boot for Intel and AMD, as well as ARM platforms, and they've also re-enabled support for Spice. For those who don't know, Spice is a way it's basically a feature for virtual desktops and remote access. And this return makes improvements for those who want to use it for both server and client applications. Alma Linux OS 10 also includes a tech preview of KVM virtualization support for IBM Power Architecture. And they've also re-added over 150 devices that were disabled for RHEL support. So you can, if you have these, there's a list I've linked in the show notes. So if you have any of these 150, this would be a good option to use so you can keep the older systems usable. Also, migration support is being actively developed to help users transition smoothly from previous versions or from CentOS-derived systems. So you have support for the Elevate project or ELEVATE project and migration tool for the Alma Linux OS 10. So that's what's in Alma Linux OS 10. Still RHEL compatible, but it also comes with tweaks for those that need them. Not familiar with what's new in RHEL 10 itself? Well, go check out the last week's episode of This Week in Linux where I talked about what's new in Red Hat Enterprise Linux 10. Link in the show notes.